Coming up on the Dave DeBaugh Big Show, I've got the most shocking Eli Manning story of all time, as Eli Manning is actually involved in a scheme to sell fake memorabilia. I don't even know what to say anymore. Go ahead and play the cool intro music now.
Presented by Seat77.com. As always, Dave DeBaugh is coming to you live from the Super Plus Seat77 broadcast studio in the heart of Silicon Valley. Now, Dave DeBaugh.
North America, welcome to the Dave DeBaugh Big Show. Today, we begin with the most outrageous story I think we have covered at least in a full week. As Eli Manning, the Gomer Pyle, if you will, of the National Football League. Look, the one kid that if your daughter brought home, you'd be like, okay, he seems tame, he seems normal, he seems quiet. I think I don't have to go hang out with him because he seems like a complete and utter bore. That is Eli Manning. And Eli Manning, though, now finds himself embroiled, and it's fun to say that word, embroiled, in a scheme to sell fake game-used memorabilia. Now, this story has been going on actually for quite a while, and I should note that the New York Giants have issued a press release basically denying that Eli Manning did anything wrong. And to the smoking gun we go, as this is what Eli Manning actually put in an email from his AOL account sent on a BlackBerry. What does that tell you about Gomer Pyle? At least it wasn't a flip phone using Hotmail. Anyways, this is what he said to the equipment manager. Two helmets that can pass as game used. Once again, to the equipment manager, Eli wrote this on his BlackBerry via his AOL account. I can't stop that. It's unbelievable that he even has an AOL account. Anyways, two helmets that can pass as game used. So apparently, Eli just likes to keep his own equipment and wants to keep it at home and didn't want to actually give away his actual equipment that was going to be sold as actual game-worn memorabilia. Now look, I am not a mathematician, but I can tell you this, that there are only 16 games, regular season games in the National Football League. Roger Goodell, you don't have 18 yet, which means there's really only 16 opportunities to sell a game-worn jersey every single year. Now, discounting playoffs and whether or not you're Tom Brady and your jersey ends up in Mexico. But so there's not that big of an opportunity for this particular market when you really think about it, unless you're dealing with somebody that wears four or five jerseys a game, which isn't Gomer Pyle, that is Eli Manning. Now look, this story, not the biggest story in the world. I mean, United Airlines. I mean, not as big as that story, or as big as the big bomb that the U.S. government dropped in Afghanistan earlier in the day. So in the scheme of things, when you see this cross your ticker tonight on CNN, and it's wasting your space on ESPN, and even Fox News will cover this story, it is hard to imagine that Eli Manning felt the need to rip somebody off like this. Look, Eli, this is my special message to you. Didn't your big brother Peyton Manning take care of you and put you in those DirecTV commercials? Are you that hard up for cash that you got to pull a little bit of a scheme like this? And look, I don't even, like, there's not even like that much money you could make off of this anyways, because you're Eli Manning. Okay. Moving on, North America. Actually, send us your emails. I want to hear from you on this. info@seat77.com. You can also catch me on Facebook, either on the Seat77 app page or the Dave DeBaugh Facebook page or Twitter account as well. Okay, on to our last story of the day. And this one hits really close to home for me. As a lifelong Minnesota Timberwolves fan, I've been really suffering for a long time. Now, if you're new to the show, you also know that I'm also a big Los Angeles Laker fan because I grew up in multiple places as a kid. Originally born in a barn in Minnesota, onto Southern California, where I was there for the Showtime era and the Kobe Bryant era. So I spent a lot of time in both of those metropolitan areas, Minneapolis and Los Angeles. So I have two favorite basketball teams. And to just sort of explain it out to you, the Timberwolves started in 1989. So when I was in Southern California, there was no basketball team for me to root for in Minnesota. So I had a choice between the Lakers and the Clippers. And let me ask you this question. What are you going to do when it's Magic Johnson and Kareem? You're going to take the Lakers every single time. So anyways, I've been a Laker fan. But as a lifelong Minnesota Timberwolves fan, I've been there since the first game. Since the very first game, very first season, I've watched this franchise be mediocre for almost as its entire existence, except for one shiny year where Kevin Garnett somehow got the team into the Western Conference Finals, which, of course, they lost. That being said, the Minnesota Timberwolves pulled one of the worst public relations moves I have seen in a long time by a sports franchise that wasn't making it to the playoffs. With two games to go in the National Basketball Association season, the Minnesota Timberwolves, with two home games left, decided it was time to unveil their new logo. Now, I want to preface this by saying they unveiled their new logo, but they didn't have any of the new uniforms ready yet. They had no t-shirts to sell in the store. There's absolutely no place you can go on the internet today, and this is 36 hours later, where you can actually buy something with this logo on. So that, let's start there. That, from a public relations perspective, is a nightmare. But the even bigger nightmare is what they actually did with the logo. I mean, if you look at the logo, it's got like SB Nation kind of, it's got an SB Nation kind of feel to it, a little bit of a Bleacher Report feel to it. It looks a lot like the Arizona Coyotes logo. And there's countless other logos that this logo actually looks like, from color scheme to the direction that they have the wolf looking up. It's absolutely unbelievable. But what was even more disturbing than the logo itself was the sham that they put on at Target Center at the beginning of the game, where they ran this video, which lasted just under 2 minutes. And this video was talking about the new era in Minnesota Timberwolves basketball. And it was this, you know, this really, you know, pretty decent, well done video, but it's talking about this new era. And what do the Timberwolves do? They turn around in the new era and they lose their last two games of the new era. The Minnesota Twins turn around and lose their next two games of the Minnesota Timberwolves new era. And then last night in overtime, my Minnesota Wild lost at home to the St. Louis Blues. The new era of sports in Minnesota left those three franchises winning zero games and losing five. Look, this logo and the rollout of the logo was the kind of thing that you would expect to see happen in the CBA, not the National Basketball Association. So to the people that are running the PR program over in Minnesota, next time you roll out a new logo, I recommend you try something called a focus group and you figure out if the logo actually resonates well with people. Will people look at this logo and say, you know, it looks like somebody else's logo? It reminds me, the color scheme reminds me of the Seattle Seahawks. Look, not a terrible thing to look like the Seattle Seahawks, but it's almost identical. I swear they used the same exact color numbers for the logo that the Seattle Seahawks use. So this is absolutely ridiculous, a complete sham. So for the PR team in Minnesota, I highly recommend next time you use a focus group, And for, but please, 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 for the love of God, next time you roll out a brand new logo, at least have some shirts that can be sold at halftime. Okay, North America, thanks so much for all of your support. Listen, the Dave DeBall Big Show, we are available all over the place. We're on Facebook, Twitter, the SoundCloud, Spreaker. Of course, our big iTunes channel is both audio as well as video. We are on YouTube and proud to say that we are on the iHeartRadio app. All right, for the Dave DeBaugh Big Show, I'm Dave DeBaugh reminding you that not everyone can be a champion, Ron Rivera, but everyone, and I do mean everyone, can act like one can. And good luck, North America, because in this era of Donald Trump being your president, you're going to need it. We'll be right back.